Students at Southfield's MacArthur K-8 University Academy aren't old enough to vote, but they've got some near real-life experience under their belts about how to do so, thanks to a series of lessons on the election. Hundreds of students were given a crash course on politics and the election process by way of the gubernatorial mock election program. Hosted by the National Council of Black Women, MacArthur students were schooled in learning about the issues and candidates of the 2014 general election.
This mock election is for children to get and understand the process of voting, the importance of voting, the importance of knowing what your rights are.
We're here because this is an opportunity to show kids about the actual voting process. We will get a chance to have them engaged in what is it like to actually go out and vote. As you know, voting is such a fundamental right here in the United States. Our country is founded upon principles of democracy, and one of the best ways to show democracy is to get out and vote.
Included on the mock election ballots were state, congressional, county, legislative, and judicial candidates, along with the bond proposal.
We know as a group that if we start with the young children that they will go home and they will tell their parents and be excited about voting, be informative about voting. And it's very important that we cast our vote for the person that we think that is capable for the job. We need people in government who will represent us.
Here at MacArthur K-8 University Academy, we're not new to voting. However, because we have student council here and we have elections for student council. But this particular instance is for the gubernatorial election, and it affects their lives tremendously. And I truly believe that why it's important, because the kids have an opportunity to talk to their parents about this race and maybe have some influence on their parents as well about their views. And so it's an awesome opportunity. I wish when I was in middle school that I had this opportunity to actually have an impact on my society at such a young age. And I think the kids really need to understand that they can have a voice even though they're not a voting age.
The final tally was intriguing, as some of the results mirrored how the election actually turned out.
Participating students from MacArthur K-8, Bernie and Thompson schools voted in favor of Governor Rick Snyder over Mark Schauer by 594 to 198 votes for the gubernatorial race. Gary Peters over Terry Lynn Land by 447 to 159 votes for U.S. Senator. Southfield Mayor Brenda Lawrence over Christina Barr for the 14th Congressional District race by 504 to 110 votes, and Southfield Councilman Jeremy Moss over Robert Brim by 455 to 162 votes for State Representative of the 35th District.
To learn more about upcoming programs and events offered through the Southfield Public School System, visit southfield.k12.mi.us. To learn more about the National Council of Black Women, visit ncbwoakland.org.